I'm Dana Gentry, Communications Director at SEIU. Today we're talking with Las Vegas Justice Court candidate Robert Kurth. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
So this is not your first time running for a seat on the bench.
It's not my first time, no.
What have you done in the past?
Well, as far as my practice and my law practice,
mm-hmm.
you know, I've been practicing law for 24 years, and I've had a general practice for the most part, where I handle people's criminal cases, their family law cases, their wills and their trusts, create businesses for them. You know, just kind of a general all-around lawyer for them.
And why do you want to be a judge?
You know, I've always wanted to be a judge. I think our community needs somebody that's going to be fair to them and understand what it's like, what the people that come before the court, what they go through, and how difficult it is on them too.
So you want to eliminate some of the processes that put people behind bars and make them miss work and that sort of thing? There are easier solutions?
I think there's definitely easier solutions. I mean, sometimes you definitely need to, you know, put the people behind bars. But I was sitting in court this morning, for instance, and I was listening to a young man before the judge, and she decided to sentence him to prison for a probation violation. But it doesn't sound like he was very, you know, intelligent, as far as he didn't pass his GED yet. He didn't understand some of the process. And I don't know if it was the best decision with his case. We have other programs, such as sending him to a regimental, the boot camp program, maybe to learn some more responsibility and then come back and, you know, have another shot. Just not fill up our prisons. But sometimes you need to.
What about the diversion programs? Do you think they're adequately funded? Do you think they need more money, or are the resources there for referrals?
We always need more money, I believe, for the programs. I don't think there's enough programs. There's not a lot of, for instance, mental health facilities when people are struggling with those type of problems, where they really need some assistance, not just to be housed and get their meals, you know.
Uh-huh. So are you in favor of the diversion programs?
I am in favor of the diversion programs.
You think they work?
Well, sometimes, you know. I mean, just like drug court, for instance. I believe in drug court. I think it's a good thing. You know, you have to look at what the percentages are, but I think they should have an opportunity to go through that process. Sometimes, I mean, it's difficult. They have to get transportation. They have to get there. And they meet other people that are, you know, abuse substances. And sometimes they fall back into that. But it's a necessary program for us to have. You know, it's all about personal responsibility.
What about racial bias in our courts? Is that a problem in Clark County?
I don't think that there's, you know, a specific racial bias, but I do believe that...
Well, I mean, statistics show that African Americans are jailed for the same offenses at a much greater rate than white people.
Sure, sure, no doubt. And I believe that's based on a lack of education. A lack of education and a lack of resources to hire an attorney. And to understand, I think a lot of people just enter a plea, go to jail when they could do something a little bit better, or they just want to get out. They don't really understand the consequences of their actions. And it's also a lack of personal responsibility, but mostly with what you're talking about with the disparate impact or treatment of you know, being imprisoned. I do believe that's more related to a lack of education and a lack of resources to hire a lawyer.
What about the ability of justice courts to collect on warrants and things like that? There are so many outstanding warrants. Is that something you're interested in reforming?
Definitely. I mean, I think we look at the warrant situation and we need to collect the monies because we need to pay for the courts and the processes and the systems. But I also think that we don't just need to go pick somebody up and put them in jail for that. I think sometimes we need to open something up, let them know, here's a time to come in, pay your fees, you know, like an amnesty program. They used to do it usually once a year. I haven't seen it on a regular basis anymore, where they could come in and take care of things and not be afraid of just going to jail.
Right.
Because it does affect them. I mean, what we see and what I've seen in my practice is usually a lower income level. They get a ticket and then they get on a payment plan and then they miss a payment and then they go into warrant. So now they have an additional payment they need to make. Then they get pulled over for, say, speeding or violating a traffic law. So now they get a ticket for driving on a suspended license because their license was suspended. They get a warrant fee. They have another ticket, which they should have been following the laws anyways, but they probably have at least another $400 or $600 in fines. They're back on payments again, and they just keep going through the same process and never get it done. We definitely need to try to do something about that.
All right, Mr. Kurth, good luck. Appreciate you being here.
Thank you very much.